Would you comment on the issue of assisted suicide, which some people see as the cure for suffering, and which...
That's the Holy Spirit saying something to you there.
And which I fear a lot of people in the West are now seeing as an acceptable solution in places like Holland and Switzerland and Belgium do. And even now with Bishop Tutu saying that he would consider that, it does seem we're on a slippery slope, and I wonder if you would comment.
I've always been a huge admirer of Desmond Tutu. Wonderful, wonderful man. But I was a little bit dismayed to learn of his recent views in favour of assisted suicide. I've always been strongly opposed to it. I understand people's desire for it, but I personally have always been strongly opposed to it. Not so much in itself for moral grounds, but because to bring about legislation to allow it would have all sorts of unintended harmful consequences. That's my view. So I hope we won't legislate to allow for it. Though, as you say, there's continuing pressure. And we've had a whole series of debates in the House of Lords in recent years. But what was interesting, when actually a bill went before the House of Commons more recently, it was decisively defeated, which was very interesting. But there's a mismatch, actually, because the Euthanasia Society and all the lobbying groups in favour continually say that public opinion is in favour of it. But the House of Commons voted very decisively against it. But whilst on the question of suicide, I think Camus is so interesting here. Camus says that the question of suicide is the only interesting philosophical question. Everything else, he thought, was just mere footling. For him, the fundamental question is, why don't we commit suicide? Why do we keep on going on, going on? Now, his own answer was a very bleak answer, of course. It was the myth of Sisyphus, that life is totally meaningless. It consists of rolling a heavy stone up to the top of the hill with great effort, watching it come down, rolling it up again, and so on forever. There's a totally meaningless exercise. But there is a kind of, for him, a kind of strange joy in just doing that. But as I say, for him, that was the fundamental. And I'm very interested, why do so many people who bear the most terrible affliction go on going on? Why do they do it? They do in the most courageous kind of way. We all know people like that. It's as though they feel that there is something great at stake in human life. It's not just the animal will to survive, nor is it, I think, just mere cowardice. It's as though people feel life isn't just a question of calculus of pain and pleasure. There is something big at stake at life, and they actually feel it's somehow important and meaningful to go on going on despite all the odds.
I would just say something very similar. I think, though, I mean, obviously one can see why people would like to think like this, and I'm very sympathetic to that. But many of these people are vulnerable, and they can come under huge pressure. And one of my deep concerns is, you know, how on earth do we safeguard against, you know, that kind of emotional manipulation? So it's one of those things where I can see a case of sorts, but I can also see real concerns. So I'm sure we'll be talking about this a lot more, but I think that it's a complicated issue.